I'm going to be talking about three ways you can DIY silk pillowcases to save money. A lot of people use silk pillowcases for their skin or for their hair, and silk can be rather expensive. If you follow my tips, you can save more money on your pillowcases. My name is Sharon. Welcome back to my channel. Make sure you guys subscribe below and turn on notifications to get the latest updates. Okay, so let's get started. People use silk pillowcases for their skin. They have been told that it can help with avoiding wrinkles, so they use it for that reason. Other people use it for their hair, like myself. I follow the curly girl method. I have wavy hair, and I do use silk pillowcase. Now, the first way that you can save money is head to your thrift shop or thrift store, like they say in the song. You don't need much money, you know, $5, $10, or whatever. You can buy a lot of stuff in the thrift store. Now, you're probably not going to find silk pillowcases. What you can do is instead head on over to the shirts, the button-up shirts or just regular shirts, and look for large shirts. You might have to get a couple, and you can kind of mix and match, make one side one color, make one side the other color, or patterns or whatever. But getting silk pillowcases, you would use the back of the shirt, is a great way. If getting silk shirts is a great way to DIY your own silk pillowcases. The second thing that you can do is only have your pillowcase be one-sided with silk, and the other side can just be regular materials such as cotton. By doing this, you're automatically having the amount of silk material you need, and you should have the cost. The second thing that you can do is use scraps. I'm going to show you my first silk pillowcase that I got 5 years ago. This came from either mainland China or Hong Kong. I'm not sure. I had to wait a month to get it. It is so torn and ripped up. So my daughter has recently discovered, you know, it's fun to rip fabric, and this is old. So it's ripped here in the corner here. It's also ripped down here as well, so it is all ripped up. Now, I was thinking of just throwing this away. I was going to recycle it in those bins that they recycle fabric. I have decided to save this. It's on my to-do list, and I'll probably do it next summer, 2019. I'm going to use this and make a new silk pillowcase out of this. So I already have it. It's free. It's just going to take my time. I probably have to buy, you know, a little bit of material, or I could use some scraps that I have and only make it one-sided. Another way to get scraps is to head on over to your local fabric store, such as Hobby Lobby or Joann Fabrics if you're in the U.S. Both of those stores often sell scraps or ends that they have, bolt ends of their fabric bolts, and you can get affordable things that way. So those are three ways that you can save money by DIYing. Of course, if you want to buy ready-made silk pillowcases, the best advice I have for you is to wait for sales and look for discount codes. We are entering upon the most frantic frenzy sale time of the year. If you're in the U.S., it's Black Friday and Cyber Monday. Just insane sales are going to take place. So check at stores. Also look on Etsy. I really enjoy supporting small businesses. There are a number of companies out there that have silk pillowcases. And, you know, look in them, see which ones you like, and then, you know, wait a little bit and see if they have a sale. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure you guys give it a big thumbs up. Let me know what you guys are using for pillowcases. If you have silk pillowcases, I would love to know if you made it yourself, where you got the material from, or where you bought it from. Let me know in the comments below. I really like hearing from you guys. Make sure you guys also subscribe to my channel and turn on notifications to get the latest updates. I will see you guys later.